kickoff weather report. It's a gorgeous night for football. 83 degrees at 7 o'clock. Slight breeze at 7 o'clock. About 6. Gorgeous night. Fans tonight, one very lucky HHS student and three of their closest friends. You get an opportunity to watch tonight's game in the comfort of the Boomer's Room, which is one of the stadium boxes upstairs right here behind you by the grandstand. Along with that, we have one dinner provided by Hermiston Athletics. Thank you to all the students who are in attendance tonight. We've had a great show tonight.
And a good evening to you. We hope to find you well as we join you high atop what is still the tallest occupiable building in Hermiston until they get that downtown hotel open. I can still see it. It is Bulldog Stadium, and down on Kettison Field, the Hermiston Bulldogs will be hosting the Mountain View Cougars. Mountain View and Hermiston, it feels like old times. You got to go all the way back to 2011, Sonny, to renew this rivalry. And it was often whichever team was on the front foot would dominate the game, but it was probably the top rivalry in the last couple of years of the IMC.
Yeah, good football played by both teams, you know, and of course my memory goes only back to 2009 because that was the year that we froze. And I think it was 2009-2010, my son's senior year when it put a little bit of snow, ice, hail, you name it, we got it.
It's not going to be like that tonight. 84 degrees right now with a partly cloudy sky. It was in the 90s today, so one of the things that will be interesting to watch is when it gets so hot like that and we had sunshine throughout the day, the field is going to keep that heat and retain that heat with the rubber pellets, essentially the chewed up tire that sits underneath the field surface itself. When it gets that hot, I learned this last year covering the Women's World Cup in Canada, 84 degrees on the field often meant 105, 110 degrees. Soccer players will tell you with their rubber cleats or their plastic, it will start to melt if you don't move too much when it gets that warm. So it was very hot today. The field itself is going to retain some of that heat for a while. This could be an interesting test, obviously not just a football skill between the two teams, but the fitness of the two teams.
It'll be an interesting test because Mountain View, to my knowledge, has not played on the field turf yet. They played on natural grass. This is going to be something different for them, whether or not, and with that natural grass, of course, that field is a lot cooler. So you're right. We'll see the conditioning of the players, and especially we'll see if cramps start showing up as early as in the first half. And if that's the case, then it could be a long night for either team.
Style and pace of play will be interesting tonight as well. Hermiston has wanted to control clock. They're not running no huddle nearly as frequently as they did last year or during the Mark Hodges era. They don't have the personnel to run quite as much, especially because a lot of their linemen have to play both sides of the ball, and they're still searching for that correct combination on the defensive line. And Mountain View is an 80% run team. They run, and then they run, and then they run, and then they play action pass, 80-20 run pass. And they're very similar in the style that they used to have, even though they've had a new coach since the last time we took on these Cougars in the Intermountain Conference. All that is part of the storyline here tonight as Hermiston at 0-2 looks for win number one in 2016, and the Mountain View Cougars look to improve to 3-0 and continue to climb the rankings, both for the OSAA and the mathematical formula, but also whether it's important or not in the eyes of the voters who vote in the Oregon Live statewide poll. This is your Sway Motors pregame show. I'm Eric Olson along with Sonny Levy as we join you this evening in Hermiston. We take our first break of the pregame show. When we come back, your starting lineups on AM 1360 KOHU. Okay, if we're actually connected, then, you know, well, are you getting anything?
It's slow. I was already open. Now it's slower than heck updating. They absolutely need to get a different thing because everybody's, their thing, as soon as the cell phones get close to
Yeah, we need something dedicated. I'm not... teach high school, not elementary school. I'm not good about sharing.
No, it's not doing nothing.
And we are back at Kittison Field and Bulldog Stadium as the Hermiston Bulldogs wait just beyond the scoreboard out to the east end here, and a little bit more cloud cover has started to sweep across the area and sit overhead. Still got a little bit of blue and the sun setting off to the west here this evening. Hopefully that is going to drop the temperature for proceedings. Hey, Coach David Faitete, second year as the head man, ninth year here at Hermiston, standing at the west 20-yard line, looking back at where his team, clad in the all-black uniforms, walks two by two across that protective matting to the field itself. Mountain View is already out, and the white tops with the black pants, black numerals and lettering, trimmed in red, waiting patiently for the national anthem here this evening. Starting lineup, it's brought to you by the Stratton Agency. We take a look tonight at the Hermiston starting offense. That's what needs to get going for the Bulldogs here this evening.
As ever, for the offense, right
side, you're going to find Tim Hermiston, Jose Mato. Left side, you're going to find A.J. Fernandez and Bo Blake. And in between all of them, the specialist for Hermiston, the quarterback is the sophomore Andrew James. He'll be throwing to Deshaun Neal, along with Tucker Salinas, who had a big week last week, including the touchdown in the fourth quarter to get Hermiston a little bit of momentum coming out of the game in Lewiston and by Moeta. And then, of course, Jonathan Ankle in the backfield, and he'll be splitting his time with Mitch Brown. I think we're both in the same mind. We would like to see the running game get established here tonight.
Yeah, for Andrew's sake, we absolutely have to have it because we need Brown, and we also need, Hinkle both to come out and light up the scoreboard together.
In these first two games, the other thing has been three and outs, and then the other offense gets a hold of the ball and goes down and scores 21-0 deficits 2 weeks in a row. It's just, it's not impossible, but it's just so hard to come back from that. And that's what Hermiston has had to try to do against Union here 2 weeks ago, and last week up against Lewiston, a team that's top.
They were a very good ball game. Colton Richardson, absolutely real deal for anybody that's out there listening for us, all of you that are listening. That was a ball game that he got an opportunity to see for the third year in a row, and it's improved every single year. You're right. I think they've got to be one of the front runners to win that Idaho State title.
I'm not entirely convinced that they didn't have the best quarterback that we will see this season with respect to but also four interceptions with 41 completions and that yardage. James is actually second in the 5A classification in both of those categories right now behind Neville of Wilsonville. Although, as that information came to me from the Oregonian's Billy Gates, I pointed out, when you fall behind 21-0, you got to throw the ball a lot more than you would be accustomed to. And so it is... one of the reasons that James has thrown the ball 63 times through the first two games. Coin toss complete, and Hermiston is going to start with the ball.
Yeah, they're going to, Mountain View deferred to the second half, so Hermiston will get the football first in this ball game.
Attacking right to left. That's going to bring us to the end of the Sway Motors pregame show. And again, those starting lineups brought to you by the Strat Agency. The Hermiston Bulldogs and the Mountain View Cougars open up Intermountain Conference play next after this 2 minute break. The national anthem on AM 1460.
Fans, will you please stand and join us in honoring America, as well as the men and women around the world in uniform protecting our freedoms, and remembering those who have paid the ultimate price preserving this great nation. With the playing of this evening's national anthem by the Hermiston High Marching Band under the direction of Mr. Sean McClanahan. Thank you.
shoulder to shoulder, this freshman class that is coming to Hermiston High School has been tremendous at their game support. The parent section is still filling in here this evening at Bulldog Stadium on Kennison Field, Hermiston and Mountain View. It is week three in the opening of the Intermountain Conference. So, just for clarification, because I've heard it again and again and again, it is just for football in the team sports. In volleyball, Hermiston is in the Columbia River Conference. In fact, they opened with a win last night in the Dalles in four sets. Soccer, and that's the same. So is cross country here in the fall. It'll be the same for basketball. The only other teams that are part of the Intermountain Conference, the tennis teams play their districts in the IMC. And these days, the wrestling team is back in a Intermountain Conference setting for their districts as well. Bulldogs in all black attacking right to left. The Mountain View Cougars with white tops, black pants, black numerals, and lettering trimmed in red. Ready to go. Cameron Houchin has a team. Right-footed kicker will drill it into the middle. And it's taken by Deshaun Neal, the three-yard line. Moving out to the left side, outside the numbers at the 20, is tripped up. And slips up to the 23-yard line. That's where the Bulldog offense is going to take over after Neal returns the ball. 20 yards, he's tackled by
Cougars, number 25,
Houchin. Check that, Houchin was the kicker. Tyler Smith, the junior, is 5'8", 165 pounds. First down and 10 for the Bulldogs. 24 is where they end up marking Neal. A generous spot for the Bulldogs attacking right to left. Here on night two at Kennison in 2016.
Andrew James,
the back. To his right shoulder, three receivers that way. On first and 10, straight drop, looking to throw. Time to throw, deep down the right sideline, under thrown, tipped away from by Muena. By the defensive back, Alex Getter, a senior who was out there on the far sideline.
Gary, that is a pass play that Bynum needs to come back and get. He could see the ball was lofted up there, but he's the one that needs to come back. He had to play defense on that and got a little bit of a break that was a little bit off the fingertips.
Yeah, and the second part of that is not all on Bynum. That ball's going to come out soon because there is a limit to how far Andrew can throw. Second down and 10 from the 24. Left hash mark set. James again with three receivers to his right. Rolling that way, dumps it into the flat off the fingertips and incomplete. Trying to get it into the hands of Jerry Ramirez, the senior H-back who was out wide into a slot position. So third down and 10, and the clock is paused because of two incompletions in a row for the Bulldogs. Anna and Neal will come off. It'll be Tyler Rohrman and Brady Christensen wide to the right. Joey Gutierrez is lone to the left. Pistol set for James. Brown will move out of the backfield to the right, flip it out into the flat that way. Brown gets out to the edge, outside the numbers, a handful of yards, up across the 25 to the 27-yard line. Fourth down for Hermiston, a fourth and seven after the 3-yard gain.
Fourth and about seven.
Damon McLeod. Is going to kick. Instead of his 15, flag out for the far sideline. And we will have our first penalty assessed of the night. Crew out of the Blue Mountain Officials Association. And it is a false start against Hermiston that will move them backwards 5 yards.
Deep to receive with the Cougars, number seven.
So now a fourth down and a 12.
And not the way you'd want to see the opening game being written up.
McLeod pushed back to his eight, will get the kick away under pressure to the far sideline, takes a Hermiston ball at the 50, inside the 40 as Jacob Ray moves away from it. Keeps on rolling. The Goldman River down to the 33-yard line where it is touched up by Herman. And the Mountain View offense is going to take over. They are led by Hermiston by a sophomore. Caden Cromwell is 6 feet, an inch tall at 170 pounds. An I formation type offense. They will just put one receiver out wide. It is Cromwell's older brother, Carson Cromwell. At an I formation behind Caden Cromwell. His brother will be in motion, left now out wide to the right side. And a toss play coming straight up the middle, bouncing to the left. Spencer Klein gets a handful to the 36-yard line. Nothing fancy about it. It's student body left, student body right.
She's good fat. Smash mouth football right up the middle, and that's what they're going to do. They make no bones about what they're going to run and where they're going to run.
Klein is the deep back in the I formation. As Caden Cromwell goes under center, he has two receivers, this one each way. Hands off Klein, running left, he's hit immediately. Is able to fall forward and get Klein just across the line of scrimmage to get about a half yard to the 38-yard line. Bring up a third down. David Faitete says, against this team, winning first down and second down of the utmost importance. Didn't win the first down, but they do win the second down. Third back is Michael Hoover. Third down and five, toss left side, Klein hit in the backfield. Jump by the transfer to high school. He's got some familiarity with this Mountain View team. And the tackle by David McLeod ends up being a loss of 4 yards. Back to the 34-yard line, and it's fourth down and eight. Mountain View will punt things away. Cameron Houchin, the sophomore right-footed kicker, is standing on his 18-yard line. Back it up, Deshaun Neal standing at about his 35, waiting. Attacking right to left if Neal gets the kick. It is angled away from him towards the far sideline and will roll out of bounds just across the 35 at about the 33-yard line, where Hermiston will take over. 9:05 on the clock in the first quarter and scoreless. But if you're evaluating and comparing to weeks one and two, the biggest thing for Hermiston is without giving up points.
And gets off in within three plays, and very nicely done by the Hermiston Bulldogs.
So the offense is going to try to get going. Peter Earl in the backfield behind Andrew James. Two receivers to the right. The H-back set up left on first and 10 from the 33. Handle Earl running left side. Outside zone, try to get to the edge, he'll be hammered. And maybe got back to the line of scrimmage before he was stood up and dropped by Klein. So one of the things about this Mountain View team, they have a very 5A look. Look at their far sideline, not a lot of bodies over there. A lot of their guys will play both ways. Klein being one of them, maybe one of the most important. I think if you're picking out guys from Mountain View who could be IMC Player of the Year this year on either side of the ball, he is their leading contender in many ways. Second down and nine, they gave Earl a yard. He stands behind James in a pistol set. Two receivers to the right, take the snap, handoff Earl, running left side again. Good blocking out there to the edge. He spins off as a tackler, gets across the 40-yard line, and is shoved over the 43. First down yardage for Hermiston, and they will move the chains for the first time tonight. Got out to the edge, and it was A.J. Fernandez that left tackle who sealed things off. Earl finally got to a opening and was able to put his foot on the ground and move James up to the 44 with 8:14 on the clock in the first quarter. Bulldogs the first down of the game. Neal will go from the left side out to the right side of the formation. That's the wide side of the field with the ball in the left hash mark. James in the pistol set, hands in front, takes a snap, turns and hands off. It is Hinkle this time. Hinkle breaks through into an open, breaks a tackle, moves across the 50-yard line into Mountain View territory to their 49-yard line with a 7-yard gain.
And that's, Eric, that's the quick hitter. That's what they got to do. Don't try and stretch this Mountain View defense. They're pretty quick on their corners, and their inside linebackers are getting out there fairly quickly. Do exactly what they did there. Get that initial block, get that hard pound, quick pound right up the middle.
Deshaun Neal in the slot to the right. Arm it out wide that way. Gutierrez left side. Play action. Rolling right. James will step up out of the pocket and shift away from the defender coming near sideline at the 35. Gets a big block. He's at the 30. Down the sideline. Spun out of bounds at the 19-yard line. And Andrew James has the big rush on the broken play and gets Hermiston down into the red zone.
A nice little 30-yard run that time by 20-yard run by Andrew James down to the 19, and just did a great job.
30 it was.
Oh, it was 30,
and
yes.
For James, it'll bring his season total above 150 yards. He is the leading rusher for this team. 7:10 on the clock, first quarter. Hermiston trying to open up the scoring. First and 10 from the 19, left hash mark. James turns, hands off, ground this time. Shifts back to his left, finds a hole, gets across the 10-yard line as he is brought down by Klein and Marr. Warren Marr, who is a 5'8 junior, makes the tackle, but not before Brown is able to rumble for 9 yards.
And Hermiston's getting it done with those quick hitters up the middle, and, you know, that's what they got to do. Right now, Mountain View is on their heels and trying to catch up.
And a wide to the right, Neal in the slot to the right. To the left side, Salinas and Ramirez. Brown stands to the right shoulder of James on a second and one from the 10 to throw. James, slant play, left side, Salinas, touchdown. Got inside of the defender, Salinas waltzes into the end zone.
That was easy, Eric. That was absolutely easy from 19 yards away just to get that quick little slant off there. He was so wide open on the inner part of the field. Looked like they were trying to prevent him from going to the corner and forgot all about the middle.
Deshaun Neal to attempt the extra point out of the hands of Salinas, who's got a good snap. The hold is down. The kick is right through the middle of the upright. 6:47 on the clock in the first quarter. Hermiston. 7-0 on AM 1360 KOHU.
Rushing, passing.
Hermiston Bulldogs with their first lead of 2016, 7-0 of the visiting Mountain View Cougars. 6:27 on the clock in the first quarter. Peter Earle will loft one down to the 22-yard line. And moving over to the left side, some space for Jacob Ray. Jacob Ray to his sideline is shoved out of bounds there by Salinas, who had the touchdown reception 10 yards Jacob from Andrew Ray James. Had the big touchdown last week, a 65-yarder at the end of the game to give Hermiston a little bit of positive feelings coming out of Lewiston last week in spite of the 37-13 loss.
And you know, Eric, that again, Tucker is a good back that makes that initial move and can make people miss, and he did a great job.
The I formation is back out for Caden Cromwell. He'll turn and hand off to Klein right up the middle. Klein bounces off of one defender, but catching back up, he is brought down after getting to the 35-yard line, barreling ahead for a 3-yard gain. Down on the left hash mark. Hermiston rotating a lot on the defensive line. Tyler Hunter will come out. Jacob Levy will come in. Klein behind Houle, the fullback. Klein again, left side. shoulders away from one defender, pushes forward, and falls up to the 38-yard line. Three more yards. But Hermiston again wins first down and second down for the most part. And it's a third and four situation for the Mountain View Cougars in their own end.
Third and about five.
You know, right now Hermiston is beating Mountain View off the line, which we've been waiting to see all game long. They're actually hitting Klein before he's able to go ahead and get to the backsides of his offensive line.
Well, motion. Carson Cromwell, right and left, handoff Klein, up the middle again, pushing the pile across the 40 to the 41. But it's still one, maybe 2 yards to go on fourth down. We'll see what Brian Crum elects to do. A 20-19 win over South Albany on opening night at home. A 24-14 win over Central last weekend in Mountain View's two non-league contests. And for the Cougars, their first road trip of the season brings them to Hermiston. Fourth down and one, and they have Houchin out there to kick again from his 25. Plenty of time, boots it away. High kick, tailing away from Deshaun Neal. And again, angled out of bounds. Inside the 35-yard line, down to the 31 this time. It's a good kick and ends up going for 31 yards, but Hermiston's offense back on the ball with 4:10 left in the first quarter, leading 7-0.
And Hermiston really being able to win the yardage possessions here, flipping the field. They're in a very good place. Anytime you can start from the, you know, outside your own 30, you're doing a pretty good job out there.
Mitch Brown will be the running back. Two receivers to the right, one Salinas wide to the left in a one-on-one. First down and 10. Hand off, Brown running left side, trying to get out to the edge. Caught from behind by Klein, bounces off of him, but is thrown down by Riley Ettinger, a junior who's 6'3", 210 pounds.
Yeah, that time again we tried to stretch the field and it's not going to work with the pursuit of this team because their inside linebackers really pursue the ball very, very well.
No gain, second and 10 from the 31, now on the left hash mark. Ramirez, the H-back, is in what looks like a tight end position to the left, standing position for him. Two receivers to the right for Andrew James. Blitz being shown off of his right side. It won't come. Four-man rush, thrown over the middle, slant play, caught by Neal across the 40 to the 44-yard line. He will push the ball as he is pushed down by Kenny Shaffrey. 3:24 left in the first quarter and a first down for Hermiston. As they look to march down the field, right to left as you look at things on the radio dial. And out on to the 7-0 lead. Hinkle in the backfield right now. James at a pistol set. So Hinkle 3 yards behind him. On first and 10 from the 43, hands in front, James turns. Play action, throws near sideline. Salinas has it on the screenplay. Bounces to his right around one tackler up to the 50-yard line. He will wait. 7-yard gain on the pass to Hinkle. Excuse me, a pass to Salinas. As Colt Ramsey, the senior, will make the tackle. It was such a good move by Salinas to bounce around the first defender. Blake Elgin lost his shoe. Sophomore has got the righty back on, didn't even have to do loop, swoop, and pull. Second down and 3 from the midfield stripe. Three receivers right side. James turns and hands off. Hinkle running left. Big hole at the 45. Bounces across the 40 and down to the 37-yard line. Hinkle a first down run and 13 yards.
And that's the type of run in Eric that we need to see. That was just very quick, get to the hole and put the head down and get what you can get.
You talk about the running back. I talk about the hole that was created by the left side there.
Yes.
Running behind Fernandez, Blake, and Colton.
Yeah, and but that's the key. You can't expect that line to give you any more time than what they did there. And he hit that hole that they made for him quickly.
First down and 10 from the 37. Still left hash mark. James looks back over to the sideline. Now will set himself with two receivers to the right. Turns and hands off. Hinkle running right side. Bounces through a hole across the 30. Down the left hash mark to the 27-yard line. And a late flag out from the back judge around where the tackle was made on Hinkle by Reed Seahorn Hurst, the junior D lineman who caught back up with Hinkle after he made the initial move.
Face masking possibly here.
It is something against the Mountain View Cougars. Yep. Face mask is the indication. 5 yard variety. So the ball is pushed down to the 22 yard. And a first down for Hermiston as they lead 7-0 with a minute 52 left in the first stanza. Attacking the west end zone. The lights are starting to take full hold as we've reached dusk here in the Columbia Basin. Anna Wright along with Christensen and Ramirez. Neal alone to the left. James with a back to his right, it's Brown. Looking to throw left towards Neal, who's behind the defender, reaches up over his shoulder, makes a catch inside the left pylon. 22 yards, score, Hermiston got it to score lead.
That's a nice job by recognizing the one-on-one coverage out there, you know, and everything that shows Mountain View is going to put everybody within 8 yards of the line of scrimmage. If you get by on the possibility of them trying to bump and run you, you should have it wide open, but it's going to have to be a quick pass, as you've been saying, and once they get it over the top, it should be wide open.
Fourth touchdown reception of the season for Neal, who's approaching 300 yards for the year. His extra point is to the right, and it misses that way. 13-0 for Hermiston with a minute 27 on the clock in the first quarter. Interestingly, they finally put a situation that they liked out there on that left side because it hasn't really mattered who the receiver was. They're putting that quarterback in a one-on-one position. So David Faitete, his first year as the offensive coordinator after being a defensive guy for the first 8 years of his career here at Hermiston, takes Neal, his leading receiver, puts him out in the one-on-one, like you said, and at that point, it's just a pitch and catch, and Deshaun blows right past the defender. He's essentially wide open.
Yeah, watching the film like we did, I watched quite a bit of this on some of their highlight plays through their first two games. They like to put him within the eight yards, maybe even a little bit shorter than that at times. And if they come up and try and bump either Tucker, whether it be Salinas, whether it be Enna, Rorman, Neal, any one of those guys, and miss, that pass should be wide open all night.
Neal is going to kick off this time. Peter Earl kicked off last time. To the right is Jacob Ray. This is angled over to the left to Colton Ramsey, who chases it towards his sideline and lets it go. Legal procedure on Hermiston. And it does appear with Mountain View's offensive unit coming out onto the field, they will take the penalty assessment and the ball on the 35-yard line. Trailing 13-0, Mountain View with the ball, 1:27 left in the first quarter. And for Hermiston, one of the guys they're missing to injury, Keaton McCammy right now with a heavy knee brace on his right leg. A couple of brothers who've come through this program over the last few years, but Keaton right now unable to put that number 22 to its full use because of the injury. Right now he's on T duty, which is not what you want in your junior season. First down and 10 from the 35. They choose to put it on the left hash mark. Play action, rolling right, pressure, dumped into the flat, incomplete. Joey Gutierrez on the coverage of the fullback, Michael Houle. And the senior has it right off of his hands.
And again, there was great coaching, great scouting of this team. They throw the ball after a play action pass in their That's what they're going to do. If they
100%
get play,
of their passes are off of play action.
Yeah, if they get play action, they are going to pass.
Jordan Bell in at the running back position, dotting the I on second down and 10. Receivers each way. Fullback handoff instead, and Houle will bounce forward to the 38-yard line down the left hash mark. John Henry line in on the tackle with McLeod. after a three-yard gain. Third and 7. Hermiston continues to win. First and 2nd down. Exactly what David Faitete said they had to do defensively here tonight against this I-formation team. In Chalk Talk, you heard the Hermiston head coach say, if they can get a couple of scores up, it forces Mountain View to come out of what they like to do. Hermiston's defense making a change on the fly when they see the three-wide formation left and a receiver to the right on 3rd and 7. Deep ball down the near sideline, underthrown, picked off by Vaimuena on the sideline. I'm not sure if he's in, but the official is going to say the pickoff is good, but he also threw a flag, and I think that's going to be pass interference. Not on Enna, but on the other defender. And Scott Hammond, the defensive coordinator, in his first year in that position, he's been the defensive backs coach for much longer. Trying to get his explanation, and it is going to go against Hermiston pass interference. I was going to say for a second there, the officials were acting like this was an NFL game and they were going to spot the ball at the infraction. It is a 15-yard penalty, but it's not a spot foul.
Yeah, it'll go from the penalty will be.
That's a 12-yard penalty.
Yeah, that's not even a good.
The line of scrimmage was the 38. The 50 is only 12 yards. It should be in Hermiston territory in the 47. And the Mountain View Cougars, Brian Crum is saying, "What are you guys doing? That's not the right spot." And now the officials are going to have to come together. But they let the chains move, so they have no idea.
So he's gonna
and now they move it to the 48, which is still 14, wrong.
It's a 14-yard penalty here, so.
That's why you go back and march it.
Yes.
You don't just get to do math on the fly. 36 seconds left in the first quarter. First down and 10 after a 14-yard pass interference penalty. Back in the I formation with double tights, handoff right up the middle. Klein's got some space. Klein barrels ahead down to the Hermiston 43-yard line. Give him 5 yards of the gain. I've never seen that. I mean, I've seen a lot of things when we go on safari here, but I've never seen the official stand and kind of look back at the line of scrimmage and go, yeah, this looks about right. It's like touch football in the yard with no hash marks. Or, you know, the last time Mountain View was here, when it was old Kennison, and there were no hash marks. Second out at 5, up the middle, a spin by Houle, and he gets a first down inside the 35 to the 34-yard line. A 9-yard gain, and for the Cougars, another move of the chains. But it will be the last play of the first quarter. A 13-0 lead for Hermiston as we go into the second quarter. At AM 1360, KOHU. Pretty easy when the first two games of the season saw Hermiston fall behind 21-0 to say best first quarter of 2016, but the Bulldogs lead 13-0 as we switch ends of the field. Mountain View attacking, though, with a first down and 10 from the 34-yard line in Hermiston territory, now moving right to left. And the white uniforms, black pants, black numerals and lettering, trimmed in red with the red MV, the traditional sticker on the side of the helmet for the Mountain View Cougars. First down and 10, I formation, tight ends each way. As Caden Cromwell goes under center, hands off right up the middle for Bell. And the second running back down to the 31-yard line. Might have actually been Tyler Smith with the carry. And it was Smith dotting the I behind Ahul. Smith is a 5'865-pound scatback junior. Got three, so second and seven. As Cromwell turns and hands off, Smith again jukes to his left and gets back to the line of scrimmage at the 31-yard line before he is stacked up by John Henry Line.
Yeah, that time there, that defensive line of Hermiston is just getting a very good surge out of this off that Mountain View offensive line and kind of negating them.
We have some type of pause. Something off to the left. I wonder if it's the light that's on over at the hammer throw cage down at West Park Elementary School. But we're going to go back at action. Pistol set this time on third down and seven. Two receivers to the right. Ball is dropped. Picked back up. The sophomore flushing to his right. Flag out. Throws to the sideline. Caught by Ray. Another flag out. Looks like my house right now. Laundry all over the floor. And we'll have to see what this third down ends up being with 10:56 on the clock in the second quarter. And Hermiston leading 13-0. Andrew James tossing the ball back and forth, back behind the Hermiston players. And there's an ominous sign for Hermiston is also back behind the players at the bench. Peter Earl has removed his pads and his jersey and being checked out by part of the medical staff here for Hermiston. Penalty was against Mountain View. And it was a big one.
Yeah, it was a 4-yard lot. The hold came on when Christensen was coming in, so it came 4 yards into the backfield, so it went from there for the 10 yards. So about a 15.
So it's all, yeah, it ends up being a 15-yard assessment back to the 45-yard line. Third down at a country mile. Cromwell, the sophomore quarterback, shotgun set, trips receiver's right side, throws high and incomplete. Howell is the receiver out there. Hinkle was covering him. Helmet off. And so Jacob Cochran is going to have to come off for a play. Just tangled up, hand fighting out on the far sideline. And it's fourth down. A country mile officially tonight is 21 yards. And so Mountain View will send the punter back out, trailing 13-0 with 10:51 left in the second quarter. Oddly, now that the sun has gone down and it's starting to cool off, the wind is also picking up. It's a crosswind left to right across the face mask of Houchin the punter, who kicks from his 40 under some pressure, gets it away, high short kick near sideline, and it'll ping off of a Mountain View player. Schaefer hit it around the 25-yard line. That wasn't identified, so Hermiston's going to get it on the 22-yard line where it went out of bounds.
Well, the one official that was trailing the play threw the bag down.
Now they get it right. So it is up at the 26-yard line.
Yeah, I was going to say, he threw his bean bag down there, and then the other official just took it back to the 20.
First down and 10 for the Bulldogs. Looking to add on to their two-score lead. Tucker Salinas, wide receiver to the left. Deshaun Neal inside of him in the slot to the left. To the right, Ramirez and Vaimuena. For Andrew James, with Hinkle to his left shoulder, the sophomore quarterback. takes a snap, straight drop, looking left, time to throw, steps up in the pocket, too high, airmailed over the top of Salinas, incomplete. Guerra was on the coverage for the Mountain View Cougars.
And again, if they're going to go ahead and go one-on-one like they are right now, Eric, had that pass been down, and that was a big game by Hermiston because Anna had him beat.
Second and 10 for Hermiston from the 26. They will shift all three receiving options to the left and bring the H-back Ramirez to the right side. Pistol set this time for James, who turns and hands off to Brown. Running right, flag out as Brown gets to the 27-yard line. Tackled up at the shoulder pads by Cochran. This flag, however, is in the vicinity of a holding penalty. Might move Hermiston back. Minute and a half, just about gone in the second quarter. Bulldogs, two passing touchdowns. A 10-yarder to Tucker Salinas at the midpoint of the first quarter, and a 22-yarder to Deshaun Neal with 90 seconds left in the first quarter to take the 13-0 lead. Neal missed the second extra point right after he split the uprights on the first one.
Well, they called it a chop block, Eric, but he was not.
So the illegal low block will move the ball back to the 15. And it's a second down and a 20 for Hermiston. Twin receivers each way for James, with Brown behind him to his left shoulder. Play action, throw out to the left side. Caught by Neal. Neal moves back to the middle of the field. Superman dives to the 20-yard line and gains 5.
Back out to about the 20.
Andrew James will walk over to the near sideline. Quick conversation with David Faitete. Head coach calling the plays, then he'll come back. And the quarterback's coach, Mike Mosier, who was the head coach at Umatilla for the past 3 years. They share ideas. Matt Bruck, the receiver's coach, is up top. The eye in the sky for them. Third down and 15 from the 20-yard line. Rolling left, James, with some time, gets a block, throws over the middle, and underthrown and intercepted down the far sideline. It's taken by Perky, I believe. And the interception was returned to the 29-yard line. So Mountain View trailing 13-0 with 9:31 left in the second quarter. Trying to take advantage of the interception. High formation, handoff line, running left, big hole, Klein at the 25-20. Shoulders down a man and rolls over the top of him to the 12-yard line. Klein rumbles.
Klein. Inside the 15 to the 13-yard line on the top of the Bulldog to the 16-10-11.
Tyler Rohrman made the stop, although he took the brunt of it. And it's a first down for Mountain View to the 12. In each of the first 2 weeks, even though Hermiston fell behind 21-0, they always got a touchdown back and were on the verge of getting a second score to get to within one. Klein again up the middle. Bounces back to his left, breaks through the arm tackle and into the end zone. A 12-yard touchdown run. The point was, the last 2 weeks, it's been an interception that changed the complexion of the game and really dashed Hermiston comeback hopes, at least in the first half. Tonight, it's an interception that gets Mountain View back into this contest. With 9:04 left in the second quarter, Klein's 12-yard touchdown run puts the Cougars on the board. And now, Houchin for the extra point. The sophomore righty kicks it low but through. And the Cougars are on the board. 9:04 left in the second quarter. 13-7 is the score.
Yeah, that time, you know, Mountain View just did a great job. They were the ones that really got off. After the turnover, they got themselves together in an offensive line that's absolutely fired through. But I tell you, Klein was a beast. That first run of 17 yards that got him into the first down, their third first down of the game, was absolutely a beastly move. One thing that we did watch here earlier, and depending upon what they want to see here, they do have a couple of really good onside kick preparations that they ran pre-game. They're very good at it. One of them is a high bouncer, another one is just a dribbler. I don't know that they would do that this early in a game in the first half, but if you wanted to change the momentum of the game and you're able to go ahead and take that one away, then this would be a time to do it.
Seems like, though, if I'm in the shoes of Brian Crum, they got the momentum just now, and the question would be, do you want to give up that field position? Neal takes a long kickoff at the 12. Neal's got a hole. He's at the 30. Makes a man miss at the 40. Caught from behind as he gets back to the midfield stripe. Yeah. So kick it deep, and Deshaun Neal will make you pay anyway.
Yeah, that's huge right there. Deshaun sat back, surveyed the middle of it, saw it, made the first cut, and then the burst of speed. And it had not been to where the kicker and the outside contained man had stayed where they were supposed to be, Deshaun would have been off to the races.
So with 8:55 left in the second quarter, Hermiston leading 13-7. Deshaun Neal's kick return of 38 yards puts them at midfield. Andrew James takes the snap, turns hands off. Mitch Brown running left side. Mitch edges outside, and he stood up there. No gain on the play. As Mountain View ended up with four white shirts at the point of attack, led by Ettinger.
Loss of the yard.
In fact, they even take a yard away from Brown. Back to the 49 yard. Tucker Salinas will be the wide receiver left. Ramirez, the H-back, is set up left. Neal and Anna to the right for James at a pistol set with Hinkle in behind him. On second and 11, play action to Hinkle, rolling right. James with tons of time. Now will pull the ball down and run himself. At the 45, he jukes to the left and is stood up at the right hash mark 43 yard line, where 17 of the 22 players meet, and then a late flag comes out from the back judge.
I believe you're going to get a late hit by the number 7 of the defense that time. But we'll wait to make sure on the call. It sure looked like a late hit to me.
It is a long conversation with 8 minutes and a second remaining in the first half. And a 13-7 Hermiston lead. Now the explanation. You are correct, it was a late hit on Jacob Ray. Personal foul will move Hermiston's offense down all the way to the 28-yard line. And a first down for the Bulldogs on that penalty. Salinas and Neal will be wide to the left with Hinkle behind James. Hermiston's sophomore quarterback, a three-sport athlete at the varsity level. Bends at the waist, hands in front, calls for the snap, turns and hands off. Hinkle running right, jukes back to his right on the jump step, gets back to the line of scrimmage, fighting for extra yardage after he was caught in the backfield by Kenny Shaffrey. He got away from Shaffrey, but Mountain View got the reserves there to make the stop for no gain.
Yeah, Mountain View came with a stunt off their linebacker. He shot the gap, and in the same note, when he shot the gap, they brought another loop on their tackle inside, and they were able to go ahead and make sure they contained that run for nothing on the game.
Second and 10. right in the middle of the field. James looks out to his left where he's got one receiver. Two to the right. Roman wide, Neil inside of him. James takes a snap. Slant play left side in behind. Salinas incomplete. Dropped. Nearly a second pick. This time it was Guerra who missed the opportunity. And Guerra doesn't just miss an opportunity for an interception. He probably misses an opportunity for a 70-some-odd yard pick six.
Yeah, that was delivered just a little bit late and after the break. It should have been out before the break came, and Andrew threw it after the break and threw it through the break of Salinas.
Third and 10, outside of field goal range. Play action, left side. Salinas has it on the court, on the receiver screen, and Salinas is flipped down after gaining maybe two. And Hermiston wants a timeout with 6:48 left in the second quarter. Leading 13-7, but it's four down territory. It'll be a fourth and nine facing the Bulldogs out of the timeout. This is not 2014 where you could have had Luis Medina try a 45-yarder, and he very well would have kicked it through. So the Bulldog offense getting an earful from head coach David Faitete. North Medford graduate played at that time. One of the coordinators was Mark Hodges, who would eventually be the head coach here at Hermiston for eight seasons, including that 2014 state championship. Retired after that. Still a teacher here at Hermiston High. Still works with the sprinters in the spring. And still is there to offer counsel when Coach Faitete wants it. His staff, though, is ever younger in many ways. Rick Wells, who came here from Buell, Idaho, a head coach there and a head coach at Madras before that, is now one of the elder statesmen on this staff. So here's the fourth and nine out of the timeout. Three receivers right for James. Straight drop, looking right. He's got time, now pressured. Dives out of the pocket, goes left side. He's got the first down, runs out of bounds at the 26-yard line. Fernandez came back and laid a block that cleared James and got him to the edge, and then Andrew did the rest of the work to get the first down and then smartly avoids contact as he gets out of bounds.
Yeah, an 11-yard run that time by Andrew. A great job of getting that first down for Hermiston.
6:41 left in the first half. And a 13-7 lead for the Bulldogs, but they're in the red zone again against Mountain View. Attacking the east end zone. Lights have taken full hold here at Hermiston. Still a warm night. Hand off to Hinkle, running left side. Hinkle bounces off of one defender. Caught at the shoes and is brought down by the feet to the 13-yard line. After a gain of about two. Second down and eight to go. Salinas alone to the left. Now Ramirez, the H-back, will move out that way. Anna right along with Neal. Second and eight. James takes a snap, straight drop, looking to throw, right side. Slant play to Neal. It's a little behind him and a knocked away by Colton Ramsey, who had the interception. And now Ramsey, a great defensive play against Deshaun Neal. Passes in the right spot, that's six. But the starting point guard is a freshman for the basketball team. And a starter for the varsity baseball team last spring, Andrew James, has that one just a little bit behind his receiver. Kind of one of those threw it at him instead of where he was going. Third and eight now. Hinkle to the right of James. Twin receivers each way. One safety back. James looking to throw. Lob, wobbly ball, right corner. Enna falling down, loses the handle, and it's incomplete. As Tyler Smith reaches down to help him back up. He was there on the coverage.
Yeah, had he not
come out of the hand as clean as possible.
Well, actually, and it wasn't. It didn't come out as clean as that. But if Enna would have kept his balance, he had that for six because he had him beat. He had the position on him, and it didn't. You're right. It was a little wobbly, but he still had the six if he would have kept his balance there because he had the position.
Still a little bit deep for a field goal. So fourth and eight. Hermiston's got the offense still on the field. From the 14, James, barking orders, takes a snap, rolling right, plenty of time to the sideline. Flag out at the goal line, rolls back to his left. James is in trouble. James is hammered at the 16-yard line. He loses yardage.
I think you're going to see a defensive pass in or holding in the end zone. Salinas was grabbed as he went by the backside safety.
Austin Markey is the one who laid the wood to Andrew James after the scramble play. And it's a second penalty by Jacob Ray on this drive that will give Hermiston new life on this drive. Now, here's the thing. It's a half the distance penalty. So it brings it down almost to the seven. No, they'll put it about the eight. And Hermiston's got a fourth and two. Twin receivers each way. James with Hinkle behind him, and I think Mountain View wants a timeout. They'll get it. 5:40 left of the second quarter. Hermiston 13, Mountain View 7. And the Cougars will use their first timeout here in the first half. Senior defensive backs had two penalties that has extended this drive for Hermiston.
Did you hear what the penalty was? I thought he said holding on the defense. That would have been an automatic first down.
Not in high school.
Yeah, but
it's half the distance. The goal.
Yeah, but the goal, holding happened in the end zone, which still would have been more than that. I mean,
it's a half the distance penalty, though, because it was at the 16. So that's why it came down to the 8. High school, you can't get an auto first down except on a personal foul.
Okay.
Bulldogs trying to add on to a 13-7 lead in the second quarter with 5:40 left in this period. Still have to convert here on the fourth and two. From the 8, ball right in the middle of the field. Trips bunch to the left, tight to the formation for Hermiston. Hinkle takes a toss, running left side. With speed to the edge, puts his shoulder down. Mountain View got their flag out on the play from the official behind everything else. I'm not sure. The yardage Hinkle gained was about 2. It is very close as to whether or not he got a first down, but the flag means that doesn't really matter. He does have enough for a first down on the yardage, but the conversation appears to be with the Mountain View Cougars.
Sean, it looks like holding.
That is the case. It's a holding penalty. And the reason that they had to see where the ball went was because Hermiston did get just enough to gain a first down on the run by Hinkle, Mountain View has to accept the penalty. If Hermiston hadn't got the yardage, they decline it, and it's a turnover on downs. Instead, Hermiston gets a fourth third down on this particular set of downs. 5:32 left in the second quarter. Looking to add on to a 13-7 lead. Twin receivers each way for James. with Hinkle behind him, a pistol set. Now Hinkle will shift out of the backfield wide right. James, straight drop, steps up, shifts to his right. He's going to go for the run. Has the ball knocked out as he's hit around the five. The ball is loose around the three. Mountain View is on top of it. Hermiston comes in and hammers a Mountain View Cougar. Flag out late on the play. Some pushing and shoving afterwards. Deshaun Neal is being shoved away from a pass of Mountain View Cougars. Mountain View has recovered the ball at the five. And now we will check on the penalty.
Looks like it's going to go against Mountain View from the difference in that they're going to retain the ball. It's going to be a post-possession penalty.
Yeah, the penalty is post-play, so Mountain View recovered on the fumble. Now we get the explanation.
Big ball, personal foul. On the
offense,
whoa. Ball was recovered by the defense, 15 yards, first down play.
So no, that was a penalty on Hermiston. And it moves the ball out to the 20 with 5:25 left in the second quarter. And the Bulldogs turn it over on a second drive. This time, while knocking on the door to go up again by two scores. Instead, give the Cougars the ball and 80 yards to go. Caden Cromwell, the sophomore quarterback, full house backfield out of a pistol set. And Mountain View's head coach Brian Crum decides, let's take a look at things first. He'll call a timeout with 5:25 left in the second quarter. 13-7 Hermiston. And we'll take it on AM 1360 KOHU.
Really?
That's all right. I'm tired of sitting here during all of this. These guys need to move faster. This can't take 45 seconds every time we throw a flag.
Yeah, I mean, they broke the huddle with 12 before a timeout was ever thrown. So that's what I'm trying to figure out, how they could override breaking the huddle and then the coach calling the timeout.
It's 25 seconds left in the second quarter. A little optimistic there. Freudian slip, not third quarter. 13-7 is the lead. We get a 3-hour and 13-minute opening night against Union. So it is still this power package, no receivers, three in the backfield. It is a single wing. Direct snap to Houle. Houle will push ahead to the right side.
Yeah, the 27-yard line.
It's either Houle or Cochran. We'll have to get this one for sure. No, it is Jacob Cochran. Cochran, who's listed as a offensive tight end, 6'3", 215 pounds as a senior. Mountain View's gone to the single wing. They gained six on the first play. Single wing out of a pistol. And Hermiston jumped offside.
Penalty marker on the play.
That'd be family there. Jacob Levy jumps offside. Sonny not quite as exasperated as he would have been a handful of years ago if David had done it.
Yeah,
quietly ignoring me right now. First down and 10 from the 31. Cockrum on the single wing, trying to run left, and doesn't really get anywhere.
That time it was direct snap to Hool.
No, it's eight still. It's Cockrum.
Number nine, Michael
Hool. Oh, no, it was Hool. You're right. My fault. Caden Cromwell's back out there. So they're going to put the sophomore quarterback back under center. Hool behind him. Klein after that. Second down and 10 from the 31. Under 4 minutes remaining in the first half. Hand off to Klein. Klein shimmies his way through defenders across the 40. At the 50-yard line, caught from behind. No breakaway speed. Vaimuena is able to chase him down. And he gets just a yard into Hermiston territory. So my question is this. That play has worked three times in a row for big yardage, including a touchdown. The goofy full house single wing thing. I don't know. That's why I'm up here and not down there. First down and 10 for the 49. Flag out. It had been a couple of plays. They're passing the ball around like a hot potato in the backfield. False start on the offense. 13-7 is the score still. Hermiston has been shut out here in the second quarter with 3:33 left in this period. Mountain View had a touchdown, but it was about 6 minutes ago. From the 46-yard line, left hash mark set, first down and 15. Just a receiver split right, Carson Cromwell, the older brother to Caden, who's under center. Motions him out to the left side. Toss play right. In the backfield, Smith running to the right side, flag out on the play after a 2 yard gain by Smith. Holding penalty on Mountain View. John Henry Line gets to make the decision if they want to accept it or not. Hermiston will accept it. Spot foul means from the 44 back to the 34 yard line. The 3:08 left of the second quarter. A crescendo of beep, beep, beep rings down from the parent section in the center of Bulldog Stadium. Led by the pride of West Park Elementary, the mom of Caden, Brenda Caldwell, just yelled hi to us up here. First down and a million after a couple of penalties in a row. Hand off to Klein right up the middle. Pinballs his way across the 40 up the left hash mark to the 42-yard line. Gain of about 7. About 2.5 minutes left in the second quarter. Bulldogs lead by 6. Three receivers are going to go out to the right side for Cromwell in a shotgun set. Back to his right as the sophomore takes a snap. Rolling right. He'll set up. Looking to throw deep downfield. As he's hit, he is incomplete. Down the far sideline. Closer to Joey Gutierrez for an interception than his intended receiver, his brother Carson Cromwell. And it's third and long. The penalties really pull them out of what they want to do. They look uncomfortable in that shotgun set.
Yeah, those penalties, the 12-yard and that, and they just could not get anything going after that.
Third down, 19 to go from the 42. Trips left this time. Pistol set for Cromwell this time. Turns and hands off, Klein up the middle, tripped up, he rolls Klein forward near the 50-yard line. It was Brad Justin, the senior who made the stop. And Hermiston is as glad as they could be to have him back as their starting middle linebacker. Giusti's tackle, after a gain of 7, will stop Mountain View with a 4th and 12, and Hermiston will take a timeout with 2:02 left in the second quarter. And a 13-7 lead. Hermiston will use their second of 3 timeouts here in the first half and have an opportunity to get the ball back with a little bit of time. This is where you'd like to see a little bit of tempo. Once you get the ball back, it seems unlikely that Cameron Houchin is going to make a mistake and kick it to Deshaun Neal. He hasn't tonight. Neal is going to walk back and put himself in punt return formation as Houchin stands at his 34-yard line. He's had a pretty sure foot. Neal is not very deep, standing at his 26. The line of scrimmage at the 49-yard line on the Mountain View side of the 50. Houchin will angle it towards his sideline, away from Neal. It'll bounce at the 26 and check up. Right around the 25, it rolls out of bounds on the far side.
That's where it'll be, the 25.
Minute 54 left in the first half. Hermiston up by 6. 75 yards in front of him.
And like you said, you know, get a little bit of what you want to see now is just getting some fluidity. Move the football down the field. Try and get into the end zone. If not, just run this first half out.
Empty backfield. 5 wide receivers. 2 left, 3 right for Andrew James on 1st and 10 from the 25. James takes a snap, straight drop. Bounces up in the pocket, rolls to his right, gets around a defender. Will throw on the run to the near sideline. Neal's got it around the 40. Tackled from behind by Adam Deem, the senior defensive back. But not before Neal gains 14 yards at a first down for Hermiston. They will go tempo. 3 receivers to the left. Brown in the backfield to the left shoulder of James. Enna alone, the receiver to the right. 1st and 10. Straight drop, quick drop, rifle over the middle. Ramirez catches it in traffic across the midfield stripe for a 12-yard gain and another first down. Jerry Ramirez, the senior in traffic, makes the catch, and it's another first down for Hermiston. No huddle again. 3 receivers to the left again. James looks back behind him as the ready for play is whistled. He'll take the snap, straight drop to throw, left side, slant play too high. Incomplete. Salinas, the intended receiver. Getter almost got it. A minute 24 left in the second quarter, and the clock paused on the incompletion of the Bulldogs up by 6. The incompletion allows Hermiston to huddle. James gets to come over and have a quick conversation with the law firm of Faye, Tate, and Mosier. Rick Wells, the offensive line coach, has moved from the box down onto the field. 3 receivers left, and Anna alone to the right on 2nd and 10 from the 49 in Mountain View territory. Blitz being shown, flag out. And I think it's early movement on the Hermiston offense. It is. Right side of the line moved, and the Bulldogs will move back into their side of the field.
Yeah, that's Hermiston's eighth penalty already in this first half. There.
Mountain View's got a pretty plenty as well. Second and 15 from the 46. Twin receivers for Neal each way. Straight drop with Brown in the backfield. Now he'll step up, juke himself away from a defender. Far sideline, Klein giving chase, and James eludes him but runs out of bounds. James, after losing 7 yards, back to the 39. Minute 15 left in the second quarter. Drive that started with some promise is going the wrong way. Hermiston fired emergency services ambulance has to leave down to the east end zone that Hermiston's attacking, but are currently 61 yards away from on third down and 22. Three receivers right and a delay of game penalty on Hermiston. Third down and 27. Back to the 34. It's almost where this drive started. Started on the 25. Third and many for Andrew James with Brown to his right, three receivers right. Straight drop, looking right. Now back over to his left. Now back to the right. Deep ball underthrown for Anna. Knocked away, incomplete. Anna covered on the play by Smith, and he ended up almost reaching over Smith and taking that ball away. It would have been over in the back, over the back in basketball, but clean out here. Doesn't matter, though, an incompletion.
Good job of making sure that that one wasn't picked up there. The only other thing I could say, Eric, is if it was the only other better result could have been, unfortunately, you don't want to see a pickoff, would have been an interception and a tackle right there. Then it would have flipped the field.
Might, yeah, you're right. Might have actually been more than they will get. We'll see what Damian McLeod can do with this punt on fourth down and 27. Mountain View's going to bring the house of McLeod. He does get the kick away. It is low. Might have been tipped. Rolls across the far sideline at the 38-yard line. And ends up being not great, but it does end up going for 28 yards for Hermiston. And Mountain View's got a minute left, trailing 13-7. One timeout and the ball. 62 yards ahead of them. But we've seen it all night, Sonny. They don't want to throw.
No. Well, you know, very evident. They've only thrown three times all night and no completions out of it yet.
First down 10 from the 38. Straight drop to throw. The sophomore hammered from behind. Picked off, and Hinkle's going the other direction down the far sideline. 20, 15, 10, 5. High steps into the end zone for the score. John Henry Line hit the quarterback Cromwell from behind, and Hinkle's into the end zone.
Wow. There's the turn of events you love to see. You know, that was an absolutely great job by John Henry. Coming in there, picking that, hitting the quarterback, picking the ball off right about the line of scrimmage, about the 38-yard line, and a 38-yard pick six.
50 seconds remaining in quarter number two. And now Hermiston will call a timeout. Because they missed the first one, I think they're looking at going for two here. Trying to get the full 14-point lead. So the line of scrimmage was the 38. Probably 36, because he caught it in the backfield because of the hit on Cromwell. You thought it was 38?
Yeah. It.
Right at the line?
Yeah, John Henry hit him in the backfield. The ball got right about to the line of scrimmage.
All right, 38-yard interception, return for a touchdown, and Hermiston will go for two. Up 19-7. John Henry is in the backfield. James, pistol set. Takes a snap, turns, hands. John Henry running right, got a hole. He will roll off of the tackler in for two. You make the big hit. Your head coach, who was a defensive man in college and had been a defensive coach until this year, is going to pay you off, and John Henry Lyon gets the two-point conversion to make it 21-7 for Hermiston with 50.7 seconds left.
Nice job that time by that Hermiston line. John Henry, you know, through the first part of it, got hit right at the line of scrimmage and then just kept pushing for the end zone.
So it was an interception by Colton Ramsey. And then the touchdown by Spencer Clyde at about the 9-minute mark in this quarter that seemed to shift momentum away from Hermiston. But the Bulldogs might have it back as they are 50 seconds away from the locker room. On opening night of the Bear Mountain Conference schedule, here in Hermiston at Bulldog Stadium on Kennison Field. Hermiston looking for their first win of the season. Mountain View at 2-0, trying to avoid their first blemish on the 2016 schedule. Deshaun Neal is set to kick again. And we will not see Peter Earle again tonight. Shoulder pads off, helmet away on the sidelines. I don't believe, well, I'm not gonna speculate, but you know, the most common thing in 2016 is some type of head injury. I don't think that that's it. I think it was something with like an arm or a shoulder. Yeah, kicked by Neal to the 10-yard line. Running right up the middle, Ray gets around one blocker, now runs into a pile of Bulldogs in black shirts. And ends up returning about 12 yards. Check that, not Ray, but Ramsey.
Yeah, Peter Earle had an ice bag on his left shoulder earlier. And it could be that upper shoulder, maybe even a stinger or something like that.
That seemed to be what they were checking out earlier in this first half. So Mountain View's got a timeout trailing 21-7 with 40.2 seconds left. Lifetime Vision Source scoreboard at halftime. Tri-Cities Prep in Irrigan up 30-13 on the Knights. I formation behind Cromwell. Cromwell will turn and hand off to Klein, but that play is not going to get off because of a flag. False start. Boy, Mountain View is piling up penalties here in the last two drives.
They have 7 on the game right now, Eric, and Hermiston has 9.
The marching band out beyond the east end zone behind where Mountain View is setting up to attack right to left away from them, getting set for a halftime show. Cromwell under center on first down and 15. Hands off, running right, some space for Klein, bounces off of the 10 defender across 25 to the 27-yard line. It's a 12-yard gain, brings up a second down and a 3. Under a half minute remaining in the first half. Mountain View trying to move quickly. Carson Cromwell, the receiver to the left. Ray out wide to the right, still the I formation behind Caden Cromwell. Sophomore quarterback turns and hands to Klein. Running right, tripped in the backfield by G. Houston. And then Hermiston is able to finish it off right around the line of scrimmage. Maybe give him up to the 31, near what they needed for a first down. In fact, might be enough for a first down. It will move the chains, so it pauses the clock with 9.4 seconds remaining in the first half. I don't know that Mountain View is going to get another playoff. They might. First down and 10. Snap does come. Klein up the middle. Edges to his right. He's tripped up in the pile. It looked like John Henry Lyon got to Klein's legs and brings us to the halftime break. 21-7 for the Bulldogs. Andrew James throws touchdown passes to Tucker Salinas and Deshaun Neal in the first quarter. Jonathan Hinkle, the pick six in the second quarter to put the Bulldogs up going into the break. And for us, the Tom Mitchell Ford Country Halftime Show is coming up. After we get back from this commercial break, we will hear from the head coach of the Hermiston boys soccer team, Rich Harshberger, off of a 3-0 win at St. Helens earlier this week. That's to come after this on AM 1360 KOHU.
Thank you.
you getting any internet service at all?
Tom Mitchell Ford Country halftime show continues on Kennison Field at Bulldog Stadium. It is 21-7 in favor of Hermiston. Night three, opening night for the IMC, and the Bulldogs should be feeling pretty well, good about how the first half went.
Yeah, I mean, despite the two turnovers, they've done very well. They've done what they set out to do, control the kind of get control of this football game, being able to run the football. And right now it's showing. Let's go ahead and start with Mountain View real quick for their offense. All on the ground. 22 rushes for 122 yards. They have one interception. 26 total plays, 0 for 4 going through the air. And the big rusher, of course, is Klein. He's got 15 rushes for 99 yards. And Gould has 4 for 18. Smith, 3 for 5. And again, 26 plays, 122 yards. Unfortunately for Mountain View, when you look at that, also 7 penalties for 64 yards. Stalled one of their last drives that they had down there. They have 7 first downs in the first half, 5 by the run, 2 by the penalty. For Hermiston, a little better result out there. We had 19 rushes for 114 yards, something that we wanted to see. During that time, Andrew James, 6 rushes for 59 yards. He had one fumble, but he's making things happen there. Mitch Brown, 4 for 7 yards. Jonathan Hinkle, something we needed to see out of him, 6 rushes for 34 yards in that first half. Peter Earl just had the 2 carries early and was 2 for 11 yards. And John Henry with the 3-yard run for the extra point, 1 for 3. 19 rushes for 114 yards. Passing wise, 18 passes, 9 completions, 114 yards, and an interception. They did a very good job, Andrew James did, of recovering after throwing that interception. Recipients of that are, of course, Deshaun Neal came back. Has 4 catches in that first half for 54 yards. Tucker Salinas, 28. Mitch Brown, 1 for 3. Joey Gutierrez has 1 for 12. And again, 9 for 97 yards. So during that time, but he does have 114 yards during this first half. Doing a very good job. Hermiston has 11 first downs, 4 by the run, 4 by the pass, 3 by the penalty. And penalty-wise, Hermiston has 8 penalties in that first half for 69 yards. So Hermiston doing a very fine job. 37 total plays to Mountain View's 26, 228 total yards to Mountain View's 122.
Tucker Salinas and Deshaun Neal. First quarter touchdown catches from Andrew James. Jonathan Hinkle, the pick six. to make it 21-7 at the halftime break. Here on the Tom Dentschel Ford Country Halftime Show, we continue. Second half is coming up at AM 1360 KOHU.
Finally. Well, I'd say give it to Klein another 15 times in this second half if that's all they're going to do is run.
Welcome back to Hermiston High School. I'm Eric Olson along with Sonny Levy, our studio engineer. Is Sydney Davison as the Bulldogs host the Mountain View Cougars. The Intermountain Conference is back, 8 teams, and around the IMC tonight, Hood River Valley is down at Ridgeview, Pendleton is at Summit, and Redmond is at Bend. The team that is the reason for all of this, the Dalles, is hosting Mack High. The Dalles going independent this year, so with a three-team league, it was kind of put this way. You and the CRC can have one playoff spot, or you can be put with the IMC, and then you guys can have four playoff spots. It actually, in football, does, I mean, to me, makes sense. There are four leagues, they're all about the same size. Top four teams from each league will get in, and then they'll use the RPI to set the bracket.
Yeah, I would say that was a smart move. Take the four over the one any day in the week and get an opportunity because, you know, with this 5A being really wide open, you got Wilsonville that seems to be up on the top along with Summit and this Mountain View team, a very good team also, but Bend. You know, we're going to be fighting it out with the Central Oregon teams for that league title, and this will be a good start for Hermiston if they can get through this second half and put it behind them with a win.
On the Lifetime Vision Source scoreboard, let's see what we can learn around the state. It is Ashland with a 21-14 lead as they are hosting Churchill. That one is 2 minutes into the third quarter. The game that Oregonian Billy Yates is at, Sunset just scored a touchdown to go up on Century 14-3. Dallas is driving, but apparently we don't put a score in that tweet. Doesn't make any sense. Tualatin 35, Lakeridge 21. That one's in the third quarter. West Lynn up on Sherwood 41-7. Sherwood's going to be 0-3 to start their second year in the 6A. Wilsonville up at half 34-7 as they are hosting Hillsboro tonight. And the halftime score we got locally from Irrigan hosting Tri-Cities Prep. It was 32-13 for the visitors from the Tri-Cities at the halftime break. Bulldogs are going to be hosting the Summit Storm, the defending 5A state champions, next week. Here on Kennison Field, it is a 7 o'clock kickoff. We'll have radio coverage for you beginning right at 5:30 as ever with the Bimart Bulldog Tailgate Show. here on KOHU, also online at GoHermiston.com. Bulldogs and the Cougars have finished their warm-up stretches here at the half after the extra 3 minutes added onto the clock. The crowd stamping the metal bleachers, bringing the noise in the stadium to a crescendo. Mountain View's gonna get the ball here to start the second half. Trailing 21-7.
Eric, we do finally got some scores coming up. It looks like in the first quarter from Bend, 21-14, Summit. Wilsonville, you said already, over Hillsboro, 34-7. Ashland, and it's now 14-13. Bend is up 21-14 over Redmond. Lebanon.
Deshaun Neal's ready to kick it away. He will angle it over to the far sideline and boot it out of bounds around the 30-yard line. So illegal procedure will put the ball on the 35 for the Mountain View Cougar offense.
And the last one there, Eric, was Lebanon over Crescent Valley, 14-6. It doesn't give what quarter they're in right now.
Caden Cromwell, the sophomore signal caller, brings his team out of the huddle. I formation behind him. Poole, and then Smith dotting the I. Motion Ray right to left. A receiver each way on first down and 10. Straight up the middle for Smith. Check that. Klein. And Spencer Klein rumbles for 7. Up to the 42-yard line, down the left hash mark. Mountain View moving left to right as we look at things. Starting the third quarter, attacking the end zone on the east end that is near the high school. We look over the shoulder of the Mountain View Cougars. See the Umatilla County Fairgrounds. Dormant right now, 2nd and 8, at 2nd and 2 after the 8-yard gain. Toss it back, Klein running right. Klein breaks a tackle, gets across the 45 and at the hash marks. Anna brings him down at the 48-yard. First down gain of 5. Still less than a minute gone in the third quarter. Hermiston with a 14-point lead over visiting Mountain View on opening night of Intermountain Conference action. Two receivers left for Klein under center with the I form behind him. Movement up front, and the near side official didn't call it. It was the far side official who called the defensive end on Hermiston's left side, Tyler Hunter, for jumping offside.
Well, it's going to go the other way. Huh?
And now the officials will come together and have a longer conversation about the deal.
Oh, they did call right the first. They started marking it back towards, pointing towards Mountain View. Wow.
So a 5-yard gain will move the ball into Hermiston territory to the 47-yard line. Right hash mark set. Carson Cromwell, the wide receiver, to the left. Jacob Ray to the right. Caden Cromwell under center tosses. Left side, run for Klein. He'll edge back to the right and some space. Check that, not Klein, but Smith. Smith down the near sideline. Cuts back to his left inside the 20. And he is tumbled, somersaulted down at the 23-yard line by Vaimuena, but not before a big run, 30 yards, down to the Hermiston 17. A minute and a half gone in the third quarter. at a 21-7 lead, although Mountain View is looking to chip into that 14-point deficit. Adam Deem is a slot receiver left. Carson Cromwell wide of him as his younger brother's under center with an I formation. Toss to Smith. Smith in the backfield is hit and dropped for a loss by McLeod. The senior transfer from Ridgeview makes a big tackle. Back to the 20-yard line, loss of three.
Great time, great job that time by McLeod coming in and just getting Smith before he can make that quick step.
Second down and 13. Toss again, Smith again in the backfield, hesitates and is hit. Stood up by Ty Kadutz. Bulldogs subbing in and out pretty liberally here in the opening Mountain View drive of the third quarter. Almost 3 minutes gone on this first drive. Mountain View down by two scores. Third down and 12. Cougars from the 20, it's two down territory. Hand off, running right, and back inside the 15-yard line goes Smith. Bo Blake credited with a tackle. Fourth and eight after a 4-yard gain. Can get a first down without a touchdown. Fourth and eight play for Mountain View. Just Carson Cromwell wide to the left. Klein is back in to dot the I behind Howell. Play action. Cromwell rolling left with time, pressured now. And on the edge, he is brought down, sacked wide out there by Jonathan Hinkle. Pick six for Hinkle made it 21-7 in the final minute of the first half. And now his tackle forces a turnover on downs with 8:14 left in the third quarter. Bulldogs back on the ball with the 21-7 lead.
Very good opening series by Hermiston. Stop making that drive by Mountain View, stall out, and good job by Hinkle on the outside staying home.
Bulldog offense with a first down and 10. Cheerleaders tossing t-shirts up into the parent section. James straight drop to throw, right side, home run ball. Diving catch on the far sideline is made by Deshaun Neal, just short of the midfield stripe. Yard gain and a first down for the Bulldogs with 8:08 left in the third quarter. Trying to add on to the 21-7 lead they hold right now. Neal in the slot right. Two receivers that way for James with Mitch Brown behind him. Hand to Brown running left. Brown's got a hole. Flag out as Brown moves in to Mountain View territory down to the 47-yard line, gaining five. Holding penalty on Hermiston, though, is going to erase the run. Spot foul's going to bring it back to the 38-yard line and bring a first and 20 up for Hermiston. Haven't seen a lot of screen action tonight. Although, the counter to that is Mountain View hasn't brought a ton of linebacker blitz pressure. First and 20. Ball in the middle of the field, two receivers left, two receivers right for Andrew James. Motions Hinkle out of the backfield, wide to the right, flag out. on the far sideline. The wind is picking up with a little bit more prominence, blowing to the north, out of the south, so it's a crosswind from the Hermiston sideline to the Mountain View sideline. False start on the Bulldogs. And this drive is in trouble before it even gets started. Back to the 33-yard line, a first and 25 now. Vaimuena alone to the right. To the left, Ramirez, then Neal, then Salinas. James looking that way as he sets himself behind center of the pistol. Straight drop, looking to throw. Over the middle, no, down the far sideline for Enna, underthrown again. Enna goes up and he will pull it in down to the 32-yard line. Jump ball on the far side. Mountain View's coaches and the defensive back who got beat, Alex Guerra, both arguing that he got shoved in the back on the play. I'm not entirely convinced they don't have an argument there, but the officials, nothing thrown on that play, and Hermiston's got the big game.
35-yard pickup that time for another first down for Hermiston, Eric.
So that's how you attack first and 25 with 7 minutes left in the third quarter. Bulldogs by 14 at the Mountain View 32. Right hash marks at first and 10. James, play action. Near sideline to Salinas. Salinas has it out on the edge. Outside the hash marks is at the 20. Tripped up, caught at the shoelaces by Colt Ramsey down to the 19-yard line.
Nice 13-yard pickup again by Salinas there, Eric. And Hermiston moving the football fairly easily now.
Lifetime Vision Source scoreboard update. Three quarters complete down in Central Oregon. Hood River Valley trailing Ridgeview 6-0.
Wow.
First down and 10. Left hash mark from the 19. Three receivers right for James. Turns, hands off. Hinkle running left. Hinkle to the edge. Outside the numbers, he's at the 15. Hammered. The ball comes loose but goes out of bounds at the 17-yard line. Ends up a 6-yard gain and the Bulldogs retain possession. Although that ball did pop out. Not quite to the midway point of the third quarter, and Hermiston is in front 21-7. Scored the first two of the game on passing touchdowns. Then an interception return for a touchdown by Jonathan Hinkle in the final minute of the first half made us 21-7. Hinkle, play action, rolling right. James gets away from a defender, coming back to the left side with blockers in front of him. To the edge down the near sideline, drug out of bounds around the 10. James scrambles for 7.
Just shy of the first at 10.
Billy Gates asked me if these were designed runs for Andrew James, because as a quarterback, his rushing total was pretty significant coming into tonight's action.
Third and about a yard.
And I said, they've run a few design things, but to the Oregonians, Billy Gates, I said, a lot of that is James just making things out of nothing. Third down and 1 from the 10. Hinkle the deep man. Hand off right up the middle. Hinkle busts through an arm tackle inside the 5-yard line, being stood up and down at the 3. He is drug by a quartet of white shirts, but it'll be first and goal for Hermiston at the midpoint of the third quarter, trying to add on to their 21-7 lead.
First and goal.
Hinkle stays in the backfield, pistol set behind James, 3 yards. The sophomore quarterback peers around, 2 receivers right for him on first and goal. Hand off Hinkle. Hinkle's got a hole. Puts his shoulder down at the goal line and pushes the nose of the ball across as he falls forward into the end zone for the 3-yard plunge.
Well, that is the way you want to draw it up. The Hermiston line absolutely, you know, getting the push, and then Jonathan Hinkle just keeping the feet moving and bowling himself over, and then getting a little bit of help from the Hermiston offensive line from behind.
The snap of Caden Caldwell is good. The hold of Tucker Salinas is good. The kick for Deshaun Neal is able to spin over and through. With 5:40 left in the third quarter, Hermiston 28, Mountain View 7 on AM 1360, KOHU. Don't worry too much about the scores. We won't deal with it for the most part until after the game. Hermiston with 5:40 left in the third quarter after the three-yard touchdown run from Jonathan Ankle. Deshaun Neal's kick is a low wobbler up the middle, picked up at the 15-yard line by Colton Ramsey. Ramsey up the middle, breaks a tackle, dives forward across the 35-yard line and ends up at the 37. Shoving and pushing and scuffling, but no yellow flags, which is a nice change of pace as Mountain View takes over. Trailing by three scores. They beat Central last week 24-14. They edged South Albany in week one 20-19. Backs against the wall, trailing the Bulldogs on opening night of Intermountain Conference action. Summit is crushing Pendleton down in Central Oregon. Ridgeview is up by just 6-0 over Hood River Valley. First down and 10 for the Cougars. I formation, two receivers right. And a handoff up the middle for Smith. Smith is spun down at the 40-yard line. Gaining 3 yards on the play after Corey Mason made the stop.
3, 2, 7.
Second and 7. Again, two receivers right for Caden Cromwell to throw. Cromwell near sideline, interception. And it's Troy Gutierrez who picks it off. Is able to get about 3 yards more. Jacob Cockrum, who is the intended receiver, check that, Adam Dean is able to pull him down. Gutierrez with the interception. Hermiston with the ball at the 41-yard line. Under 5 minutes remaining in the third quarter, up 28-7. And trying to make it more. There was a feeling, or at least I had a feeling, that the first 2 weeks weren't indicative of what 5A football was going to be like. That Union team from Vancouver and the Lewiston Bengals would be top probably 3 in 5A. James to throw, far sideline, out route, a little bit underthrown to Rohrman. But Tyler is able to catch it, gaining 5 to the Mountain View 36-yard. Now they make it to 37, so pull it back to a 4-yard gain for Rohrman. And a second down and 6 from the right hash mark. Rohrman is wide right. Neal is in the slot that way, short side of the field. Salinas alone to the left. James, pistol set with Brown behind him. Turns and hands off. Brown up the middle, edges to his right, puts his foot to the ground. He gets across the 35 to the 33 on the hash mark. He has stood up and pushed backwards. In on the tackle was Brent Waller, the junior defensive lineman who's 260 pounds. Gain of 5, 3rd and 2. On the right hash mark, 33-yard lines where the nose of the ball sits. Same formation, 2 right, 1 left. Ramirez, the H-back, is offset to the left behind the left tackle. James peers around, goes into his bend, hands in front, turns and hands off. Brown straight up the middle. Brown is hit, and again, grabbed by Waller, who pulls him back. Maybe a yard for Brown, but it was not enough for a first down. Four down territory, however, for Hermiston at the 32-yard line.
Red Wall stop.
Fourth down and one. Under 3 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Hermiston 28, Mountain View 7. James. Hard count, Mountain View jumped all over the place, but Mountain View is pointing at the interior of Hermiston's offensive line. Did one of the Bulldogs flinch on the hard count? They did not. 5-yard penalty against the Cougars. And a Hermiston first down on the penalty as the ball is moved to the 27-yard line in Mountain View territory. Bulldogs attacking the west end zone. And on first down and 10, Andrew James will have a trips formation to his left. Hinkle, the back, is to his right shoulder. As James, hands in front, takes a snap, straight drop, looking to throw. Blitz coming right up the middle, spins away from it, out to the right sideline, throws to the sideline, tippy-toeing the sideline. It is a catch for Hermiston, for Salinas, who, no, check that, not Salinas, but Anna. I'm sorry. We'll get it eventually. Jerry Ramirez is the one who makes the catch out there on the sideline. Jerry should like that mistake. I gave him a couple of inches in height there. 7-yard gain to the 21, second down and 3. Two receivers left. James turns and hands off. Hinkle running right. Stutter steps. Now launches forward as a flag comes out on the far sideline. Taken down at the legs by Dean. Hinkle gains a yard to the 20. But I think that's going to be a holding penalty out on the far sideline.
And once again, a big thank you.
2 minutes, 18 seconds left in the third quarter. And the Bulldogs with a 21-point lead looking out onto it.
Athletic director Larry Usher. Holding, number 16 on the offense, 10-yard penalty.
It was wide receiver holding penalty. Move the ball back to the 30-yard line. Got a second down and 13 facing Hermiston. Deshaun Neal is the receiver to the left. Tucker Salinas will go wide of him now out near the numbers. Ramirez inside of them on second and 13. James with a back to his left, rolling that way. Out to the left hash mark. James and Al pull the ball down and run. Spins off of a tackler. He breaks a tackle at the 25. He's at the 20. Breaks another tackle inside the 15 and hit at the 13-yard line. Andrew James. Taken down by Dean.
That was determination. Kept him going. Nice little spin moves. Ducks ahead and ducks under a couple of tackles. Another first down for the Hermiston Bulldogs.
Under 2 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Bulldogs looking out onto the 28-7 lead. Hinkle behind James, two receivers right. The sophomore quarterback turns and hands off to Hinkle. He dropped it. He turns back and dives on it. Hinkle recovers for Hermiston. And then a penalty comes out. Did somebody jump on Hinkle late?
The second guy in, it was number 23.
It was a late hit penalty. So half the distance to the goal line. We'll move the ball down around the 7 or 8. Call it the 8. second and eight for Hermiston. 90 seconds left in the third quarter. Mitch Brown, the senior running back in the backfield in a pistol set. James with Brown behind him. Turns in play action away from Brown. He rolls to the right side. Flag out downfield. James comes back to his left. He's going to run. He's at the five. Cuts back to his right on the left hash mark and is brought down with a waist tackle around the 3 yard line. Saving tackle made by Colton Ramsey, who's probably been the defensive MVP for this Mountain View team. He's made a lot of saving tackles. Yeah, defensive holding was the type of penalty it looked like was going to be thrown, and that's what the early indication is. So Hermiston's got to decide what they want to do. They could go half the distance to the four or take the result to the three. However, you take the penalty, you get another down. Second down and one. It was a weird half the distance if you ended up at the 3 yard line. James turns hands off to Brown. Brown stuck in the backfield, will shimmy away from one tackler, but then is hammered for a loss by Riley Ettinger.
Yeah, that time there, the Hermiston line absolutely looked like it sprung a leak because Mountain View brought four people and nobody could cover anyone. Brown was hit 4 yards deep.
Jay allows break for Mountain View, makes it third down and six from the seven. Could get a first down without a touchdown. On the third down play, James has receivers each way. Looking to throw right side, lobs it into the right corner, a shove into the back of Deshaun Neal, but it was way too far for Neal to pull it in. Jacob Cockrum on the coverage. So fourth down. And there has been no indication that Hermiston wants to try for three. Up 28-7 with just 5.8 seconds remaining in the third quarter. This is well within Deshaun's range. It would be about 5 yards further than an extra point. And it's right in the middle of the field. But Hermiston's going to go for it on fourth and six from the seven. John Henry Line is the back to the left of James, in there to protect. Flag out on the far side.
Penalty marker.
A year ago, this would probably be a no-brainer because Hermiston had Freddie Rodriguez, the star, one of the stars of that incredibly talented Hermiston boys soccer team, doing double duty and doing some kicking. Ball start for Hermiston is going to move it back. Now it's five. Hermiston's going to take a timeout. With 5.4 seconds remaining in the third quarter to talk about a fourth down and what has now become fourth and 11 from the 12. And a 28-7 lead.
Eric, what's happened is the last couple of motion penalties or false start penalties, our right side tackle is bobbing a little bit. And that's what he tried. He just went up and talked to him. The official did and told him what he was doing. And, you know, you can get away with it at a certain amount, but once you get up in your three-point stance in the line, if you bob that head down pretty hard and they think it's going to entice them, that defense, they're going to throw the penalty on you.
Bulldogs next week are going to be hosting the Summit Storm. Mountain View on the road again, although it's a short trip for them, to the Redmond Panthers. Redmond tonight is at Bend. Summit is hosting Pendleton and on their way to a win in that game. Bulldogs' next road trip is actually down the Columbia River Gorge to Hood River. Fourth and 11 from the 12. Motion John Henry line out of the backfield right. James blitzers all over the place and a flag is out on the near sideline. Dead ball, false start, 5 yards. This one game from the near side, so the left side apparently. And it has become a fourth and 16 from the 17. A couple more of these and you can quick kick. James takes a snap, straight drop to throw, steps up in the pocket. Down the left side, into traffic, jump ball, and the end zone. Deja Vu pulls it away from two defenders for the score.
Wow. And there's the length of Deshaun Neal coming in. You know, and I'll have to say this myself, there's no way that should have been completed except for the fact Deshaun Neal has so much length in his arms that he went up over the top and actually looked like he pulled it away from him, back over the top and pull it in.
Length and strength, because it's not just that you get your hands to the ball, but it's that you're able to rip it away. That should have been picked off. Now Neal for the extra point. Good snap, good hold, kick is up. It is true. And at the end of the third quarter, it is 35-7 for Hermiston on Kennison Field. You're listening to it on AM 1360, KOHU. Touchdown reception for Deshaun Neal, his second of the night in the final seconds of the third quarter. Make it a 35-7 score after three quarters of play. The Hermiston Bulldogs are on their way to an opening win of the 2016 campaign. After losing their first two, Deshaun Neal just kicked one all the way to the end zone. Nice boot from Deshaun. And it'll be at the 20-yard line. Lifetime Vision Source scoreboard. The Umatilla Vikings are 3-0, winning at Enterprise 21-7 tonight. Section with an I believe we will win chant. They've been full throat all night. A 35-7 lead for Hermiston. And it is probably a very appropriate chant. Now Mountain View's got to go shotgun. Two receivers right, one to the left. And it's going to be a direct run right up the middle. Big hole, big run, up across the 35, down the middle of the field, all the way to the 40. A 20-yard gain on what is essentially single-wing football for Jacob Cochran.
Okay.
Cochran, the senior. Two receivers right again on first and 10 from the 40. And he's going to direct run again, left side, edges back to his right. It is, it's not Cochran, it is Poole. Single wing run to the right side. He's got some space, bounces back to his left across the 40, inside the 35, dragging defenders all the way inside the 30, down to the 27-yard line. Finally brought down by Deshaun Neal. Down and 10 for the Bulldogs, 10:35 left, for the Cougars, 10:33 left in the fourth quarter. Mountain View trailing Hermiston 35-7. They're gonna go back to I formation on first and 10 in Hermiston territory at the 28-yard line. Toss play, Klein up the middle, Klein bounces across into the second level, inside the 15, down to the 14-yard line. 14-yard gain and another first down for Mountain View. Bulldog motto this season has been finishing. And right now, they're in a situation where they need to really pick things up on this drive. Toss play again, Klein up the middle. Klein gets down to the 10-yard line, a 4-yard gain. Because Mountain View is just running straight at him right now.
Well, and that's the thing, though, Eric. I mean, they can let Hermiston, let him run up the yards on the run. Mountain View's got to come up with four scores just to tie this ball game up right now. They don't have enough time left on the clock to, with Hermiston possessions, to go ahead and run the football every single time. They're going to have to break something and break loose with a pass somewhere.
Second down and 6. Toss to Klein. Klein running right. Klein's got a hole. Klein tripped up at the goal line. He's in for the score. So the extra point for Cameron Ouchin. As Mountain View scores for the first time since the 9:04 mark in the second quarter. Ouchin looking around, he doesn't have 11 out there. So Mountain View's got to run one on late. The extra point is up and good. 9:15 remaining in the fourth quarter. 35-14 in favor of Hermiston. Mountain View gets on the board now. We revisit what you were talking about earlier. The Mountain View Cougars, Ouchin was practicing all sorts of different styles of onside kicks, different lengths, different speeds, different heights. Probably kicked about a half dozen of them or so. And that's actually quite a bit of strain on a leg to take that particular type of kick. But they worked it a lot of different ways. And in the end, he hammered a couple of really good ones there. So this was all before Hermiston was out. They were in the locker room at the time, probably an hour and a half or so before the game.
They got every hands person you can think of, Hermiston does, going out there on this kickoff right now, Eric. There's not one person that's not a receiver or a running back that's going out on the field.
Klein, the touchdown run, his 20th rush of the night. 140 yards, his second score.
Salinas, Anna, John Henry Line, Ramirez, and Tyler Worman, all on the front line for hands.
Klein's going to kick it to the near side. That's going to bounce off of Worman, ping backwards, pile around the 45-yard line. Hermiston looks to have a black shirt there with the ball, and it was Damian McLeod who is able to end up with the possession. That was a tough one for Mouchin, and Hermiston gets the ball to bounce their way to keep possession with 9:11 left in the fourth quarter. And a 35-14 lead for Hermiston. Mitch Brown is in the backfield. H-back is set up to the right. Hermiston was short a player. It was Worman the receiver. Worman keeps moving tighter the formation right. On first and 10, hand to Brown, running right side. Brown stood up right at the line of scrimmage, the 45. Tim Treloggen with the tackle.
Wow, that was a hit there. That he got stood up, and then Treloggen just came in and pasted him.
Salinas is wide to the left. Werman's going to go that way along with Deshaun Neal. So trips options left on second and 10 from the 45. Hinkle in the backfield takes a handoff, running right again. Hinkle to the edge and gets a couple with a flag coming out at the end of the play. Hinkle gained 2 to the 47-yard line, but this is probably going backwards.
Hermiston's got to settle themselves down. They got to settle themselves down. They got to remember, they got to go ahead and come out here and get this, keep moving this football.
Wow.
A defensive block in the back is called. And Mountain View's defensive captain, Spencer Klein, steps up to the official. And I think his question was, I'm sorry, what?
Yeah.
Moves the ball into Mountain View territory down to the 43-yard line. First down and 10. Clock is spinning, 8:22 left in regulation. Bulldogs 35, Cougars 14. James with Hinkle behind him, turns and hands off. Hinkle running right to the edge. Stops, comes back to his left, gets a couple, flag out on the play. Holding on Hermiston.
See, and this is just exactly what Hermiston doesn't need. They don't need that clock to stop at all, and the penalties are just absolutely starting to really mount up. That was Hermiston's 16th penalty for the game. Mountain View has 12 in the game, and this last 8 minutes, Hermiston can't afford to go ahead, even though it's going to take 3 scores to go ahead and tie this thing up. They can't afford to keep stopping the clock.
First down and 21 after the penalty. James hands off to Hinkle. Hinkle running left, flag out on the play. Hinkle across midfield, bounces off of a tackler inside the 40. He rumbles down to the 39-yard line. This flag came for the umpire. The previous one came from the official, the referee. The line judge had the one before that. So now the question is it the head linesman's turn on the far sideline? A personal foul hands to the face against Mountain View. 15-yard penalty. Again, there's no automatic first down on that. Oh, it's 15 yards from the end of the play, though.
Yes, he had
and so Hinkle does get credit for that
16-yard run.
The run, yeah. And so it's down to the 24, so there is a first down on the play.
Up, somebody's just returning the flag to the official.
Come on, guys, we can run a play. I'm talking both sides now without a penalty. Hinkle takes a handoff up the middle, running right, bounces to a tackler inside the 10, right on the number 10. He's knocked down. So down to the 8-yard line he goes.
Another 16-yard run for.
And we did it. A football play without a penalty. Mountain View's got an injured player back behind the play. Although Luke Schultz, the sophomore, was able to get up and under his own power walk to the far sideline. 7:22 left in the contest. Hermiston 35, Mountain View 14. Bulldogs looking to put a final signature on this IMC opening night win. Jonathan Hinkle in the backfield behind Andrew James. H back to the right. Two receivers left, first down and goal from the 8. Play action. Down into the flat, tipped and caught by Ramirez. Ramirez hauls it in. Ramirez held back up by Klein, as Klein and Waller were out there to make the tackle. Second down and goal for Hermiston out on the left hash mark. Handoff Hinkle running left. He's caught immediately and might have even lost a yard as he's spun down out at the 9-yard line left side. Just past the midway point of the fourth quarter with Hermiston in front 35-14. Third down and goal from the 8. Three receiver options right for Andrew James. He's got a one-on-one left. Blitz being shown on his backside. It comes. Full house blitz for Mountain View. James scrambling, throws to the end zone. It is knocked down incomplete.
Pass broken up in the end zone by the Cougars.
That's the pass that Andrew's going to have to learn and mature on there, Eric. That it's not there, don't throw it. Don't try and push it into where it's not available.
Barn burner down at Ridgeview. Overtime. 6 apiece. Both teams looking for their first win of the season. Deshaun Neal is going to try a field goal from 25 yards out, left hash mark. The wind is blowing right to left, so a crosswind for him. He's got plenty of power, wide right. And then Neal gets hammered. And Tucker Salinas got his palms to the sky going, how'd the kicker get hit like that?
Especially with the white hat looking right at him.
With nothing out there. Place for discretion. it comes to the hanky. It did get into the end zone and through the end zone, so it's effectively a touchback. And Mountain View will have the ball on the 20-yard line. Trailing 35-14 with 5:25 left in the contest. Michael Houle in a single wing set with a back behind him who ends up being a blocking back. Houle coming left side behind his guard. Gets a handful up to the 26-yard line.
I said, Eric, I'll take that every day. I'll take that every day, having your quarterback take a direct snap and a run or a handoff to the back with 5 minutes left in the ball game. I mean, if there's no urgency out there, maybe they just don't have that deep threat like they thought they did, where they were able to get it over the top of Central for two, for a touchdown in the air, and against South Albany for a touchdown over the in the air.
But those plays would have come on play action plays. And Mountain View calls a timeout with 4:39 left. This is their thing: is in obvious passing situations they struggle. They don't have enough receiver options and. A quarterback who can really air it out. Those play action plays are coming off of one-on-ones, and so they're in a situation where this is really what they have, is this single wing attack. If you're Hermiston, you do want to get a stop, though. Not another consolation touchdown to get this one to 35-21, even if you're going to win the thing. So it's overtime for Ridgeview and Hood River Valley. Six apiece. Out of the timeout. It will continue with this single wing for Houle. Houle on second and five. Looking to throw, launches it way downfield. Roerman in coverage, and it is incomplete on the far sideline. The back judge says no catch. The side judge says he had it.
And the back judge read it correct.
Back judge wins the argument. Jacob Ray, the intended receiver. Clock is paused with 4:33 left in the fourth quarter. And Hermiston leading 35-14.
So is there a penalty now?
They're gonna call it a catch.
Oh, you're kidding me.
Scott Hammond, the defensive coordinator, is incensed. Joey Gutierrez is saying to the back judge, you said it's incomplete.
Who caught that anyway?
Jacob Ray caught it, allegedly.
Yeah.
To the 39 on first down and 10. Right hash mark set. Houle will run down the right hash mark and gain three. Some extracurricular pushing and shoving as it becomes a rugby scrum. 3 yard gain for Houle. It's not no huddle, there's not an incredible amount of urgency. It's a little bit odd because it's single wing. It's either going left, right, or center. Second down at 7. 4 minutes left in regulation. 35-14 Hermiston. Houle, straight up the gut. puts his shoulder down, breaks one set of tackles, breaks another set of tackles, bounces out to the right side, outside the numbers around the 23-yard line. It's a first down rumble for Hool. It ends up gaining 16. First down and 10 for the Cougars. Clock is paused. The chains are set. I don't know why there's no... Yeah, Mountain View will call it another timeout. So they'll have one remaining. 3:33 left in the fourth quarter. First down and 10 for the Cougars from the 22. And this is just an example of an offense that isn't fully in sorts, because the big thing is when you get a first down, you have to be ready to get to the line and run another play, because that's the only time right now when you can easily stop the ball, stop the clock.
Yeah, there, like you said, there's no urgency whatsoever in the Mountain View Cougars at being ready to get right to the line of scrimmage, you know, after a first down, and or even not a first down, and either having to spike the ball to save some time or get that playoff.
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, you get that first down there on the long run, you can spike it or you can run another play. I mean, if you're just going to run another run play, run the same play again and then call the timeout on after the first down if you're going to stop the clock there.
Yeah, I would agree with that. I mean, that's that would be the smart way to get most out of your clock that's remaining.
3:33 remaining. First down and 10 out of the timeout. Hool takes the snap, runs right, gets out to the edge, breaks through into the second level, tripped up as he somersaults down to the 8-yard line. And it was Vaimuena who just barely got his hand on the shoe top. See, this is what I was talking about. That's a first down run down to the 9, and so Mountain View's going to get on the ball. And Hermiston's going to have to call a timeout because they were trying to change personnel and they didn't do it fast enough.
Yeah, there was only 14 of them on the field.
Well, and so, I mean, if you're going to, if I'm going to sit here and Monday morning quarterback Mountain View, I got to do the same there. Assume now that they've made the mistake once, that they're not going to make it again. And so you can't make subs after the first down, after they make a first down, for that very reason right there.
Exactly.
Not that it matters that Hermiston had to call a timeout, but it pauses the clock again.
It ran 7 seconds off the clock from the last play, and they picked up a first down out of it. Like I said, Hermiston, had they not gone ahead and tried to sub, this thing would be down probably under the 3-minute mark right now, or fairly close.
3:26 left, Hermiston 35, Mountain View 14. Cougars trying to get some consolation. This kind of feels like week one when Union had the big lead and Hermiston made a comeback, although it would have just taken all sorts of miracles on 11th Street for Hermiston to give up their score. Hool running right and gets stopped at about the 5-yard line, gaining 4. I guess it'd be miracle at Highland Avenue.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, and right now, see, they're not going to call a timeout right now, and Hermiston's got to be able to... Well,
they shouldn't, because they only have one left. And they're going to need it in case they turn the ball over. Running left, Hool trying to get to the edge, gets outside the hash, gets outside the numbers, at the pylon, reaches for it, and he's in.
Touchdown.
5-yard touchdown run for Micah Hool. So the extra point from Houchin can cut this down to a 14-point deficit for the Mountain View Cougars.
If 7, Cameron.
Kick is good. 35-21 with 2:50 left in the fourth quarter. On AM 1360 KOHU.
Somebody needs to let Tyler Rohrman know that after that ball has hit the ground. Because that last time, yeah, went right through his hands. Now they changed it up. Good move that put Ramirez on the outside. They flipped it. They put Rohrman on the far side.
Well, they're still trying to figure out where they are.
Yeah.
I mean, they're pointing all over. Get this one set. 2 minutes, 50 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Hermiston's got the hands team out. As Cameron Houchin, the sophomore kicker, tees the ball. Again, set up to kick towards the Hermiston sideline. Houchin will kick it. Top heavy ball taken by Deshaun Neal at the 50-yard line. Neal's gonna try to run back to the middle. He is caught from behind. And Hermiston will have it at the 48-yard line after the tackle by Tim Matralock.
Great job by Deshaun that time. Going up and getting an attack in the football, coming across and picking it up before it ever got a chance to have a chance of being touched by a Mountain View Cougar, and doing a good job. And chances are you take a chance at doing that, but you also get a good opportunity of maybe breaking that thing.
Yeah, the kicking team's got to wait for it to go 10 yards. The offensive team or the receiving team does not. First down and 10. Pistol set, James with Hinkle behind him. From the 48, hand to Hinkle, running left. Hinkle to the edge, cuts back to the middle, gets away from one tackler, is bottled up.
Number 28,
and Hinkle gets back to the line of scrimmage. No gain, maybe even lost a yard.
Number 72.
He did, back to the 47 yard line.
They marked him back up to the 48 again. One side, they're not getting together. The far side official marked him back a yard, and this guy down here didn't move.
Second and 10. James looking at the back judge, who's looking at the right arm with the wristwatch. Hand up in the air, James will take the snap. Hand to Hinkle, Hinkle running left, cuts back to the middle again, breaks into Mountain View territory and is brought down by Lauren Marr after a 9-yard gain to the 43-yard line in Mountain View territory.
Just a reminder, Bulldogs will be next Friday against the Summit Storm.
Cougars can stop the clock once, trailing 35-21. This is the play for Mountain View. They have to get a stop here on 3rd and 1 from their 43. James looks to the back judge. Minute 20, and his hand goes up to signal 5 seconds left on the play clock. Hand to Hinkle, running left, got the space, got the first down to the 41, got the 2 yards he needed, and that should do it for Hermiston. Mountain View can call a timeout if they'd like, but the Bulldogs have sealed it.
On Hermiston's 20th first down of the game.
It's out on the left hash mark, first down and 10 from the 41. Bulldogs are actually in a situation here where they wanted they could kneel on this thing. James, though, with Hinkle behind him, takes a snap, turns and hands, Hinkle running right, Hinkle trying to get to the edge, outside the hash marks, outside the numbers, 35, 30, and Mountain View is able to shove him out of bounds. Down the 29-yard line.
12-yard pickup by Hinkle that time.
But he ran out of bounds, so it stops the clock with 41 seconds left. First down and 10 from the 29-yard line. Now Hermiston is set in the victory formation. Theirs is a little bit interesting because James takes everything from the pistol set. So he takes a snap, he will back off. Mountain View's actually not rushing him, so James now can wait and wait and wait, and he'll take the knee with 33 seconds left. It's going to partially depend how quickly they set this ready for play. And that should do it.
Yeah.
The Mountain View Cougars are moving towards the 50-yard line. Hermiston will do the same. Bulldogs do not need to snap it again. They're standing there looking. Now the horn will sound. 35-21. Hermiston hands Mountain View their first loss, and they pick up their first win of the 2016 season. Deshaun Neal catches two touchdown passes from Andrew James, who throws for three. Jonathan Hinkle, a touchdown run, and the pick six that changed everything at the end of the first half. And the Bulldogs are winners on the opening night of the Intermountain Conference schedule. The teams shake hands. We move to post-game thoughts on AM 1360 KOHU.
Yep.